Today, there are more choices than ever when it comes to tapered leaders for fly fishing. So which formula is actually the best? And which formula will easily allow you to adapt to the various conditions when you're hunting for sea bass? Hi and welcome to Go Fly Fishing. Today we are here at the Go Fly Fishing Sea Trout Lodge in the southeastern part of Norway. And today I'm going to show you how I tie my sea trout leader rigged with two flies. When I'm hunting for sea trout, I use the single-handed rod. And it's usually the 7-weight, 9-foot rod that I use. For that rod, I have two fly lines that I use for almost all my sea trout fishing. I have the floating line that I use when I'm fishing in shallow waters. And if I want to go a little bit deeper, I use the full intermediate line. My leaders are about 9 to 10 foot long, so they are almost the same length or a little bit longer than my fly rod. And on the market now, you have a lot of leaders on the market. But one thing's for sure, that you need that visual buffer between your fly line and your fly if you want to catch fish. The first element that I'm going to use for my leader today has been a game changer for me. So I'm going to use a poly leader, also called a versi leader. And just to get the confusion out of the way, the only difference between those two names is actually the name. So the versi leader is made by Rio and the poly leader is made by the manufacturer Airflow. So it's actually the same. You can also find some other manufacturer of the same product, but I think Rio and Airflow pretty much owns this product. And today I'm going to tie my leader in with the poly leader made by Airflow. The poly leader is actually a knotless tapered monoline that is coated with a tungsten material or with a plastic floating material. So it's actually the same as your fly line. So the next step in the process is that I'm adding 1 3-millimeter tippet ring, and the tippet ring is serving as a connector in the middle. So I connect the poly leader to the tippet ring, and then I have two tippet materials that I have to add to get the leader completed. And that is, I add 5 foot of tippet materials in fluorocarbon, and I use the 0.28 for that. And that's for my main fly, and that leads the leader up to total 10 foot, so it's 3 meter long. And for the dropper fly, I use 0.40 fluorocarbon, and you can only use a small piece of that. You can decide how long you want the dropper fly from your main leader, but that's my main leader setup. And now I'm going to show you how I tie the knots and everything, so enjoy. So we start with the full intermediate fly line here with the integrated loop at the end, and then we have the full intermediate 5 foot 1.5 meter poly leader with the integrated loop at the butt section. So we just take loop against loop. That's really easy to do. So in there, and you have a full integrated loop against loop from the fly line to the poly leader. And now I'm going to connect the end of my poly leader to my tippet ring. So I'm going to take the tippet ring inside of here, and I'm going to use the clinch knot to connect the poly leader to my tippet ring. So that is just one loop here and 7 turns, 6 and 7. Then I'm going to go back here and towards here, loop here, you see, so you can tighten like this. Then it's very important that you moisture the line, and I will go in with this material here to hold the tippet rings, because the tippet ring is only 3 millimeters, so it's actually a little bit difficult to do this. So I secure the tippet ring there and I pull the line, and you have a perfect clinch knot to your tippet ring here. Then you can use the clipper and take the rest of the leader off, and then you have perfect clinch knots to the tippet ring. So then I'm going to attach the fluorocarbon tippet material that I have. This is the 028 that I'm using here now. So I'm going to do the same here with the tippet rings. I'm going to take it in here and I'm going to use the clinch knot here as well. So 7 times around here as well. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to put it in here again, tighten it up. Same here, important to moisture the fluorocarbon, and then tighten up. And if you do the clinch knot correctly, the tag will stand out 90 degrees from the clinch knot, as you can see here. So you trim that up with your clipper. And now you actually have the leader completely if you fish with only one fly. So then you can just attach your fly and you're ready to fish. So as we are fishing with 2 flies on the leader, I'm now going to tie in the dropper fly. And here I'm using fluorocarbon as well, but here I'm using it in 040. So I'm using a thicker fluorocarbon for the dropper fly. And that is because if it should be tangled up with the main leader, it's easy to make it tangle free again. So I'm using here. The same here, I use the clinch knot with 5 to 6 or 7 turns. And that'll be perfect. And here we go. In here. That as well. Here also very important that we moisture the line as well. Here. And then we go in with the clipper here and take off that line then here. So now you have the perfect leader fishing with 2 flies. So you have your poly leader going in one way, you have the fluorocarbon going out to the main fly, and you have in the bottom here, you have the dropper fly going out. So now I'm going to connect the fly to the end of my leader. So here I have a bait fish imitation, and I want to tie this in with a loop knot so it can swim free in the loop, so I get the most movement out of my fly as much as possible. So I started with a loop, 1 time into the loop, and then it goes to the fly, and then I will go back to the loop again and tighten a little bit up so I can see how big my loop should be. Hold it there, then 4 turns around, 3, 4, and then back into the loop again. So like that. Hold the line, take it through, moisten a little bit, and pull. And then you have perfect loop knot for your fly. So then it's just to trim off the rest, and the main fly is ready on your leader. So then I'm going to tie in my dropper fly. And as my dropper fly, I'm going to use a small gummerus imitation. And I'm going to use the same knot that I'm used on the previous fly. So a loop knot. So I'm going to start with making a loop, going once through the loop, then into the fly, then back to the loop again, so you can find out how big the loop should be, like that, four times around, like that, then back into the loop, tighten it. Very important that you moistened the there, and then you have the loop finished here, and you can just clip off the tag end here, and you're good to go. This is how I tie my sea trout leader running with the two flies, and I hope you enjoyed it. So thank you for watching this vlog episode, and please comment down below. I really want to know what kind of leader system you are running on. And I'm also going to write down my email address in the description. So if you have any questions about the leader or something else, don't hesitate to contact me. And before we turn the camera off here now, I have some exciting news as well. I've been contacted by a couple of manufacturers that produce new equipment and new stuff for us fly fishers. So I'm going to do some product reviews in my future vlogs, and maybe one of the products is something that you actually need. So I'm really looking forward to that. Please follow my YouTube channel, and I will see you next time, and remember, go fly fishing.